Now, Israel's new government has been sworn in. It's the most right-wing government in the country's history. Well, this was the scene inside Israel's parliament as it voted to approve the new government led by Benjamin Netanyahu. The alliance, consisting of ultra-Orthodox Jewish and nationalist parties, is seen as the most religious and hard line in the country's history. Consequently, it has stirred domestic and international unease, with protests taking place outside of the same parliament building. Well, the BBC's Yolande Nell is in Jerusalem and told us more about the new administration.
We have a very familiar face back as Prime Minister, Benjamin Netanyahu, but this is a very new-look governing coalition. He's teamed up with ultra-Orthodox Jewish parties and ultra-nationalists to form his new government. And I think now we have his Likud party, a right-wing party, appearing as the most moderate in the coalition. And it was very much remarked upon that actually they had elected as the new parliamentary speaker a man called Amir Ohana, a man who is openly gay. And it'll be the first time that someone who is gay has taken up that position. He addressed his husband and children who were sitting there for the parliamentary session. But then you have new ministers who are being sworn in at the same time, who are people who are very much opposed to his lifestyle. And one of the proposals that they are pushing forward, that they have put on coalition agreements, is to go for a change in anti-discrimination laws so that actually businesses in Israel would be able to refuse to serve people on religious grounds. And the concern is that that could really affect the LGBTQ community, also members of Israel's Arab minority. There are other things too, which were really animating the protesters who I joined outside the parliament for a time. They're very worried about another plan, which is to overhaul the legal system so that Israel's parliament would have much greater power to overrule Israel's Supreme Court. Of course, that affects checks and balances in the system, and many people connect that to the corruption trial that Mr. Netanyahu is still on for charges which he denies. But people are saying that he should not be allowed to make changes that affect the independence of the judiciary because he has at the moment a conflict of interest when it comes to that. Lots more besides. A lot of people mentioned to me the fact that this far-right extremist, a man who has been convicted in the past for racism in Israel, is now Israel's national security minister responsible for the police. He'll actually have unprecedented control over the police because of new legislation that was passed, which he demanded to join this coalition.